Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well and life is treating you right. Yet another video, a get to know me video, where I tell you how I came in Italy, how life has changed, how I met my baba watoto and all that good stuff. So let's start from the basic. We met in 2005 in Nairobi. He had come as a volunteer. I remember they were building kindergarten, a school. They were building a school in Kibera, and I had just started my career as a kindergarten teacher. We met at Consolata Church. I was just coming out of the English Mass, and he was right after the English Mass was the Italian Mass. That day he told me, you know, he never goes to church. Even here, the only time he has gone to church is when we were baptizing our kids, and that is like 5 years ago. He's not a church person, but when fate wants you to meet, it will do everything to make you meet. That day he had come at Consolata Church because he was feeling bored, and it was a Sunday. He was here, he was not going to Kibera that day. He used to go from Monday to Friday, and he wanted to hear some Italian, whatever it was, even if it was just to come to Mass. I was just coming out of the English Mass, and I was holding my sister's kid. So when I came out, I saw this tall guy with the long hair. The hair was shaggy, eh? It was long, but it was not shaggy, like it was dirty. Oh my God, it was not neat, let's say that. And so he saw me coming out to the church, like, hi, hello, you have a beautiful daughter. I said, thank you, but she's my niece. Yes. Ah, you come to church here, what are you doing here? Can we start just a small conversation? What are you doing here in Kenya? You live here? No, I don't live here. I've come here for 90 days because we are funding this school in Kibera. And you, what do you do? I say, I'm a kindergarten teacher. Ah, yeah, 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 whatever. And we made small conversation. He said, do you worship here? I said, yeah, we usually come here. In fact, I was a choir member at Consolata Shrine. So I went home because my niece was hungry. She was around 1 year old. She was hungry. And he said, maybe next Sunday we will meet. Next Sunday, he was there waiting for me. And after the Mass, we went to, this time we did not even enter the Italian Mass. We went to Side Center to take some coffee and just talk. He said, he told me why he has come to Kenya and all these things. He just wanted to have a new experience and all that jazz. I told him, just started teaching kindergarten, my hopes and dreams. It's like, yeah, it's good to have a friend here. And so we ordered coffee, and I remember that time I had like 200 bob. I had 200 bob, and when it was time to pay, we spent like 150. I paid for me and for him, because I didn't want this guy to think, now I've seen a white guy, I just want I've seen a meal ticket. No. And even out of like, he's a visitor, he's a guest, he's a visitor in Kenya, why not treat him? So when I paid that 150, and I remained only with 50 bob, remember I had only 200 bob. That was for transport. So he was shocked. He said, oh, thank you so much, thank you so much. So every time I would come from work, we would meet, have coffee, until he had like only 1 month remaining for him to be in Kenya before he flies back and comes back here in Italy. So he said, where does your mama live? I said, mama lives in Nakuru. One day we can go as friends. And I thank God he was not pushy. He was a gentleman, let me say. So before he left, I took him to home to Nakuru, and all hell broke loose. The minute my shosho, who is 100 and something now, saw him, she called me in her room and she said, wow boy, marehemu koroni. Let me translate for those people who don't speak French. At one boy, why have you brought a colonizer in this house? I've had enough with the British. colonizers. You know, my Shosho was born in that era. In fact, she saw the First and the Second World War. I said, no, Shosho, not every white man is a colonizer. And I insisted, he's just a friend. Ah, okay. And then after some time, he left and he came here in Italy. We continued chatting. Then in 2016, he came back. And this time, he asked me, do you want to be my girl of red? I said, why not? And I remember we stayed together for 9 months. This time he stayed in Kenya for 9 good months. I don't know, I think we are husband and wife. And my mother was so angry. She was like, I thought you're going to have a church wedding. Now you're doing this, come we stay with this mudogo. And I remember I would go to school, and then he will go to, this time he will still continue going to Kibera, and we'll meet in the evening. We're like husband and wife. And he invited me in Italy in 2007. I remember I came here in August 2007. After another one year, we had not seen each other, 11 months. So I came here in 2007 just to visit, and I remember being shocked by everything. First of all, at the airport, no one was speaking English. Second of all, the food. The weather was like Kenya, because in August it's like it's still summer, so it was not bad. But I stayed here for 3 months. So I stayed August, September, October. I went home by the end of October. I had a 90 days visa, the maximum they can give you as a tourist. So I experienced a little bit of autumn, and autumn was not good. It was foggy and all that. I remember I could count days as to when I'm going to go back to Kenya. Came here, visited, met his parents, whatever. Then I went to Kenya. Next year, the whole of 2008, we did not see each other. He came in 2009, January 2009. And then in April 2009, he said, come, let's get married. We cannot do this long distance relationship anymore if you're serious. We got married in May 2009. In February 2010, your girl was pregnant. Like, I did not waste time. It's like, and in 2012, I got my boy. So I had two kids in 2 years. I remember it was not easy. I was like, what have I done now? But now seeing my children growing together, my daughter is 8 and my son is 6. I am happy to see that they've grown together. They have, by the way, they have the best bond because they grew together. I remember I came from the hospital when my daughter was only 2 years and 2 months with a newborn. And I remember coming in this house and saying, it's not here, it's not like in Kenya, you can have a house help. Here, there are no house helps. I remember my sister, when she came to visit me last year, she was shocked that I don't have a house help. Here, you don't have a house help. So you have to do everything. I remember coming from the hospital with a newborn, and in the house I have a two-year-old, and I was like, oh my God, I have bit more than I can chew. But that year flew by very fast, and when my girl hit 3 years, at least she went to school, to kindergarten, daycare, she went to daycare. And at least I could breathe. At least I had just this little boy at home. In the beginning, yes, it was not easy because I was doing driving school when I was pregnant. I had to learn a new language, and it will take you like 3 years for you to learn a new language. I wanted to learn everything, because when you come to a new country, the more you learn, the more you try to know things, the better for you. But if you come here, I've seen so many Kenyans coming here and just staying in this group of Kenyans where they've been here for 20 years and they don't even know how to speak Italian properly, because they are a group of 10 Kikuyus or whatever. So if you want to learn a new language, don't be scared even to use broken Italian. I remember even I would go to a shop and speak my broken Italian with no fear. And that's why I have learned now. I'm very fluent. I'm not even bragging, but some people, when they hear me speaking in Italian, they tell me, wow, bravissima. Anywho, life has changed in these 10 years. economically, politically, and everything. When I came to Italy, there were jobs, and then I think in 2012, Italy was hit by the worst economic crisis, and 2012 around there, and things went haywire. The jobs that were mostly for immigrants, now even Italians started fighting for those jobs. Like, let me, for example, taking care of old people. When I came here, you did not even need a certificate. You did not need to go to school for you to be able to work with old people. Or you just need to go and get that faster. 6 months, they teach you and you get a permanent contract. Now, even people who have degrees, they are not getting jobs here. In fact, most young Italians are running away from here, going to different countries to look for a better future. Because some of them are going to Australia, to America, whatever, Germany, to look for a greener pasture. There are no jobs. Even those jobs now of cleaning old people, Italians are fighting for them. And this has caused a rift, because they are saying, some of them are saying, you don't have, you people, you black people have come here, or you immigrants have come here to steal our jobs and whatever. Now, even having a job here as a black person, some of them will look at you sideways, like, why do you have a job and us Italians don't have a job? There are so many companies that went down. We thank God that my husband's family company, at least, it stood the test of time, because even them, they had to leave some people at home. And even so many imprenditori, what is imprenditori? So many guys who had companies and went bankrupt, and some people even killed themselves because maybe they were in debt up to here. And you know, the banks, they don't care, there is a crisis. If they gave you a loan, they want it back. So in that way, Italy has changed. Like, there are no jobs. Let me tell you, there are no jobs. If you don't have maybe like a push somewhere, like if you know people. But if you don't, now the jobs, people are scrambling for the little jobs that they are around. And now, there being no jobs, people are taking advantages of others. Like, some will give you a whole load of hours to work, but they're paying you the same. Like, if you have 14 hours, they're paying you 8 hours. And because you need that job, you have to stay and work. There are so many Italian people who are begging in the street. Some of them are eating at Caritas. Caritas is this organization where they provide food for the less fortunate. Politically, everything has changed. Now we are smelling a lot of racism encounters. Some of us people, there is a lot of intolerance. Like, even now, walking in the streets, you are scared because you can see all these stairs. Even those people who are, those racist people who are hiding now, are coming out because they've elected this guy who is telling them the problem of Italy is because of immigrants. Yes! There has been an influx of immigrants. Like, every day there are boats of people running away from war, running away from tribulation, from their countries, and so many people have died in the sea. Like, nowadays I don't even watch news, because just seeing bodies and bodies of Africans, kids, children, floating on the sea, it makes you sad, you know. Yes, some of them look at you really, but they're like, oh, Africans, they steal. In fact, when you're walking on the road, especially these old people, when they see you, they will take their bags and hide it. And I just laugh, because some of them, you just look at them and they look riffraff. You're like, what do you have to be stolen? Some of them, even in the bank, they will be staring at you like, what is this black woman doing in the bank? And we are not all the same. Just there, like, there are some Italians who are not good. It's the same way there are some Africans who are not good. We cannot be all the same in this world. Just like all Italians are not mafias, You know, but most people, now that there's this climate of racism, the racists have always been there, but now they are more bold. Like, so if you like this kind of videos, please just leave your comment down below and I can talk about other things that you'd want me to talk about. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and see you in the next video. Ciao.